Zane Davidson survived childhood cancer and now his family and advocate Kari Rahat, WHO's daughter passed away from childhood cancer, are fighting to find the environmental cause. Michelle Pemberton /Indistar. Kari Rahat, left, Stacey Davidson, center, and Zane Davidson, right. During a Ring the Bell party, Zane, who survived acute lymphoblastic leukemia in 2014. Davidson at his family home in Morgantown Industrial. On Saturday, September 30, 2017. Kari Rahat, WHO's daughter, passed away from cancer, and Stacey Davidson are working together to link environmental causes with childhood cancers in Johnson County. Photo, Michelle Pemberton /Indistar, by photo. For Stacey Davidson and Kari Rahat, Christmas came a bit early this year. It wasn't so much what they got, however, as what they did get, Michael D'Urso as the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency's Toxics Chief. Even more, it was a gift they somewhat gave themselves. Over the last several months, the two Johnson County moms have worked tirelessly to raise awareness about D'Urso's ties to the chemical industry and his lax views on dangerous pollutants, including one believed to be poisoning their community and children. So when Davidson and Rahat heard late last week that his nomination to lead the EPA's toxics office had been withdrawn, the sense of relief was overwhelming. Since we have been so busy fighting to keep him out the last few months, we really never had the chance to think, what if he is elected into this position? Davidson told Indistar. Elected, he would be detrimental to our children, ourselves and humanity as a whole, she added. For him, it is business. For us, it is absolutely personal. Photos of Zane Davidson hang on a tree during a Ring the Bell party celebrating his defeat of childhood cancer at his family home in Morgantown Industrial. On Saturday, September 30, 2017. Zane, who lives in Johnson County, was diagnosed with acute lymphoblastic leukemia in 2014. Photo, Michelle Pemberton /Indistar. Davidson and Rahat live in Franklin, Industrial, where as many as 45 children have been diagnosed with cancer since 2010, three came in just the last 6 weeks, and two within 2 days of each other. A majority of the cases are diagnoses of rare blood and brain cancers, which are uncommon in children and can frequently be traced to some external or environmental factor, according to research. But it gets even more personal than that for these two moms. Zane Davidson, 13, rings the bell to signify he is done with chemotherapy and done with cancer. The Johnson County 8th grader was diagnosed with a rare form of leukemia in 2014 in an area identified as a potential cancer cluster. Photo, Stacey Davidson. Davidson is stepmom to 13-year-old Zane Davidson, who conquered cancer in September after 3 years and 3 months of chemotherapy to battle a rare form of leukemia. Rahat lost her daughter, Emma Grace Feedley, in 2014 from a rare brain tumor. The artist, swimmer and singer would have been 16 in July. As parents, we go out of our way to make sure our kids are healthy, get their vaccines, go to the doctor and eat healthy and organic, Rahat said to Indistar. But when your kid is like mine and ends up with a brain tumor that is almost never seen in kids, you ask yourself, where did this come from?